Hi, welcome to the Getting Started with MobiControl video series. I'm Chris, one of the principal instructors at SOTI, and I'm joined by David, fellow principal instructor.
Now, in this video, we're gonna walk you through everything you need to know from logging into the SOTI MobiControl interface for the first time to navigating it and managing device details and groups.
Whether you're setting up your first device or organizing your fleet, this will give you the essential steps to hit the ground running.
All right, well, in this case, the user is already logged into SOTI MobiControl. At the very top, we can see the blue ribbon where you can find the help area. You can have the notifications, which are relevant for the user that's logged in. And right next to it is also information about the user that's logged in, where they can change their personal preferences and change things like, for instance, the language. So then it adapts to the needs of that specific administrator. Now, Chris, tell us a little bit more about the hamburger menu that's on the other side of the blue ribbon.
Absolutely, David. So all the functions of a day-to-day admin can be found here. It's broken down into basically three sections. The top section is for general device operations. The middle section, under configurations, is where the administrator can create and define solutions they need based on the Lego pieces they add to the intended devices. The bottom section is system settings, mainly used by the system integrators. These are settings that would affect the entire instance, and only a qualified person should have access to those settings. This includes platform integrations, directory and services integration, logging level, etc. But David, there's one down here called System Health. Tell us a bit more about it.
Well, this area is going to offer you as an administrator a view of the current status of all of your entire system. Now, this is an overview of every single component that is part of your instances of SOTI MobiControl. However, for premium support customers, you also get the advanced analytics section. Advanced analytics sections, think of it as sensors that are going to tell you the state of the computers or the servers that are hosting any elements of SOTI MobiControl.
Thanks, David. So going back to devices, let's move on to groups. David, why are groups so important in SOTI MobiControl?
Because we use groups to configure devices based on membership. When you enroll a device for the first time, you're gonna have to define a group that is going to be hosting this device. Now, it's important to know that devices need to belong to at least one group, and devices can only belong to one group simultaneously. When we create configurations, as you will see throughout this series, we're going to typically apply those configurations to a group or a series of groups. Now, any groups inside these groups, the subgroups, can inherit that configuration as well. The first thing an administrator needs to do is create their group structure, and we recommend to focus into using distinct business operations where the devices are actually being used and can be configured for different types of functionalities. Now, you can also combine that with location, application, function, or, any combination of the above. Think of it as a membership that provisions you and your devices with services, functions, and benefits depending on where those devices live. Now, Chris, can you show our audience how to create groups?
Absolutely, David. So it's quite simple. So in the upper left corner of SOTI MobiControl, we have a handy plus button, and I have two choices here, root and virtual. We're gonna focus on root, and we also have within the root group the ability to create a nested group or a child group. So I can right click on the group itself, I can choose add group and give that child group a name. We can also configure certain group items as well. So if I go back to a group I'm already using, I can simply right-click on it and execute some actions based on the available devices in that group, regardless of OS. I can also click around to the other various groups, such as View All, to basically see that I have different visibility based on what I click on.
Now, it seems to me that you are assigning filters based on group membership, correct?
That is correct.
Now, talking about filters, let's talk about SOTI Search. Essentially, this functionality allows us to take any property that we can read from any of the devices that we manage and use that property to filter devices based on that. So imagine that, for example, we have the need to get all the devices that are online and that are running a specific version of Android and that are made by a specific manufacturer. Chris, can we do that? Can you show us?
Absolutely, David. So if we go to the top of the screen where SOTI Search actually resides, I can click into this and identify the properties you mentioned. So for example, I'm looking for devices that are online. I'm also going to use an AND function here to specify the OS and the device family platform. So I believe the requirement was 10 or above, and a specific manufacturer as well. I'm going to hit the forward arrow on the far right, and this will again apply the filter to locate those devices.
I really like how human this search looks. It's very simple and very intuitive. Now, Chris, what if I am going to be using this filter over and over and over? Is there a way to save it?
There is, absolutely, David. So on the far right of the SOTI search bar, there is a save icon, which I can click on to actually save the search. So here I can give it a simple name and click save.
And what if I need to reuse it? Where can I find that?
If we go to the far right of the console itself, to the gear icon next to my all devices filter here, I can basically see my saved searches from the past, as well as delete them, and also see that they are tied to the permissions of my user.
That looks very handy.
Absolutely, it is.
All right, so let's clear this specific filter, and let's talk a little bit about something that's very useful, which is the charts that we can see at the bottom. Now, Chris, help us design a new chart. Would you be able to create a chart where we can actually see all of the devices that are online based on the manufacturer that created those devices?
Absolutely, David. So we go to our chart section at the top of MobiControl. I can click on the arrow and go to the far right, and I have an option to click on the Add button here. From here, I can choose to either edit a built-in chart or create a new custom chart. In this case, we have two properties we're looking at, two devices online, and sorry, what was the other one, David?
Manufacturer.
Manufacturer, that's correct. So if I'm going to choose in this case here a stacked variant of the chart, in this case a stacked donut chart, which is two properties combined into one chart. So I'm going to search for the first property, which is the agent online status, which is actually available at the top of the search options there. And the second property is the manufacturer of the device. So type in the word manufacturer. I click save, and this will now provide me with my chart on screen there.
That's very, very simple. And what happens when you click on any of those items?
Well, any of the items in the chart, if I click on it, it will apply a filter to the device list down below and focus just on those devices.
And I can see that filter right on SOTI Search. That's great.
It's fantastic.
All right, so I love what I'm seeing so far, and let's talk a little bit about that big area that's right below those charts. And this is what we call the column view. Now, columns are very flexible in SOTI MobiControl. Two things is that you can size it. For instance, I can take the device name and I can make it longer so then I can read it all. But they're also movable, meaning that, for instance, if the model is a little more important than the manufacturer, I can move it to the left of the screen or the right of the screen, so then it actually makes more sense to me. Now, this view is also very important if I want to send bulk actions. By clicking at the little check mark at the top, I will get a list of actions that's common to all of the devices that I'm targeting right now with this view, and then I can send actions to these devices. We're gonna explore device actions in just a few moments. Now, from the operator's perspective, I can also create new views. Now, if I deselect this and I go all the way to the right where it says column view, I can actually create something more than the default one. For instance, if I click the plus button, I would like to ask you, Chris, if you don't mind creating something that an operator will need. For example, I want to add the IP address, the MAC address. There you go, the MAC address. The SSID of the device, maybe also the wireless network status. So what kind of user do you think will be able to benefit from this, Chris?
Definitely more of an operator or admin type persona.
There you go. Now we can save it, and you're gonna notice how all that information is going to appear. Remember to give it a name as well that makes sense to that operator. And once we create it, we will see it. Chris, what if we need to send this information to, let's say, a manager or someone who needs this to make changes to the infrastructure?
Absolutely. So David, if we go to the upper right corner of the device view, we can click on the share icon here, and we have two options to either download a CSV to my local machine or email the CSV to another operator.
So we can then get all this information, add it to a CSV, and send it around.
Absolutely.
Well, that's perfect.
Now that you've learned the basics of admin login, navigation, and managing device groups, you're ready to take the next step.
In the next video, we're going to dive deeper into customizing your devices with profiles, policies, as well as packages.